Mundial de Jesus Christus. Amen. Ai pre, ora quinesias, sub elixiam co, ig esser paetum co, elixi gam co, urbe sanctinas ierpegi, sans me alamazor, dur mes aesor, Gifto mes espantis mer, cum bestia mectum medos barba nas, yet mi nanibus mesi fortitur, alum quas mesi chale, sicoe apa mitium, yem solutium, yem pa avidiam same, us samo secutius yem zala chana sambati manna serna stot, ihae des padela Yeah.
Lord Sanimon, yes, in that correct, and it's an altitimot. Alleluia, Horti.
Oh.
of the living and of the dead, and to you is befitting glory, dominion, and honor, now and always and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Good morning.
Good morning.
To you guys here and you guys there at home. Yes, you've got it correctly. We had some technical difficulties this morning. So we started a little bit late. Not so much difficulties, but the camera and how it was showing wouldn't cooperate. Thankfully, Deacon Matthew was persistent with it and made it saw things his way, so you could see things more pleasing to you horizontally than vertically. I want to follow up on an important email that I sent to everyone last week, that we're in the beginning stages of phase one in opening our church, gradually, little by little, safely. So those of you, and some have already, some of you who wish to come during the week and light your candles and say your prayers, you know my number. I get your number, you go by. Please contact me so we can schedule an appropriate time and day that's good for you. I'm here and good for others, and making sure that we balance which chapels we use and on which days we use them to make sure we're taking as many precautions as possible. And we shall go on with this new normalcy until things get back to maybe the way they used to be. We'll see. Meantime, we're still here. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I forgot one thing, I apologize. I want to thank those of you who have sent really nice, thoughtful, meaningful notes to me here at church regarding the efforts of those of us that are here to be able to bring Barbara into your homes. We have Deacon Matthew Panada, our choir director Adrian Damian, Diane Regan, Jordan Paray, and Susan Segarian this morning. And also to your kind and thoughtful and generous donations, showing your appreciation for what we're doing to continue our tradition. It does mean your letters and your words mean an awful lot, and God will bless you abundantly. In the ancient world, and perhaps in some places today, the guy who held the lowest place on the totem pole of authority was given the job of tending the flocks. This person had the responsibility of leading the sheep and other grazing animals to new pastures and to find fresh water. This person, again, low, probably some of the lowest on the authority totem pole, then had to defend these animals from would-be predators, and then he had to go out and find the lost ones that had strayed. His was a humble job because it was considered menial and indelicate by most. The shepherd for whom we're talking about literally lived among the flock and slept across the doorway of the fold to keep the sheep in and to keep the wolves in the danger was indeed thankless and dirty work. Yet Christ sat amongst his followers in the thick of that ancient culture and said, and still says to us, I am the good shepherd. I think today's world misses the impact of those words. We have a rustic, but a rosy view of Christ as a shepherd. Maybe an artistic view that we're used to seeing of Christ as the shepherd may not be so realistic in terms of being a true shepherd. The sovereign of the universe, Christ, humbled himself and got his holy and divine hands dirty while working directly with the errant, willful, and sometimes stubborn humans. Now, a minute ago, when I brought to you, to your attention, the image of how tending to a flock required lying across the doorway of the sheep pen. The reason for that is simply showing that Christ became the door for us, and he tells us, I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved and will go in and out and find pasture. And I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. Jesus Christ sacrificed his sinless and his perfect life as the Son of God for the great flock of humanity, for you and for me, so that absolutely anyone at all who chooses to believe in him may enter God's fold. And once we're inside, here's the best part, we are unconditionally loved. We are eternally provided for, and we are sought for when we wander, and we are protected from our enemies. Christ is mankind's shepherd. And thankfully, we are more than just a herd to him. We are his children. He knows everything about each one of us. He knows our name. He knows our character. He knows our flaws, our strengths, our weaknesses. And he loves us unconditionally with all of our many human imperfections. So I ask you, what better way to show love in return than to know his voice, to recognize his voice, to follow his voice wherever he leads us, each and every day? All we need to do is be open-minded and listen to that voice. Go inside the door, and we're with Christ, where we are always eternally protected, loved, and cared for, this day and every day. Let us not hold.